relation to the capacity and reductions of government funding. I have been a public sector leader for many years, and I was leading the public sector organisation in 2009-10 as the chief constable. So I'm very familiar with having to manage significant cuts to budgets. And no public authority, public sector leader, I think, has been immune
council's ongoing improvement journey will require significant financial investments. Now, I think we've seen the lack of financial investment, partly the denial of funds from central government, which seems to disproportionately hit the city, has meant problems with capability. So that means the £16 million energy bill of the ASCO is a direct result of that. There have been subjective failures on top of government cuts that are not the responsibility of government, and the audit committee has got to look at that. My question is that when, I think Grant Thornton said by 25-26, 98.2 million gap, when you've got that pressure, doesn't that actually make the recovery process much harder? It reminds me of the American general who says we've got a bomb in the village to save the village, and I just want to know what you see as the escape route from this kind of cycle of cuts leading to lack of capability, etc., and that causing a block to us developing the transparency, the efficiency, the stewardship that we need.
Thank you. it's not, you know, embarrassing information will come out. It's inevitable in any organisation. I've managed information government services in all local authorities, and every single one has the same concerns about disclosing information. But we need to change that and have all the services on board with that. And I think we also need to accept that in that journey, we will find that there are requests for information where we simply don't hold the information, because one of the obvious issues that came out of the Calendar report was the poor quality of record keeping. If we go about it and make that, undertake that review and implement that review in an open and transparent way, then I think we will have that review. And unfortunately, it won't happen overnight, but you have my commitment, and I'm sure everybody around the table is committed to that journey, because as I say, we've all got that interest in transparency, and along that journey, being able to put some of the things behind us because we've been open about it. So hopefully that gives members some assurance. I'm more than happy to come back with the products of that review, and I know it's something the commissioners have been pressing us for, and I know the Secretary of State has been pressing us for it.
Thank you. I'm going to bring Jackie in a sec, but I think that in terms of that regular reporting, I think is important. I think that that is something that's supposed to add to our action tracker going forward.
Given that at the audit committee that we both attended, I'd asked you a question on how you'd actually found out who had disclosed to you the information of the problems of the utility contract, and you very in a transparent way you informed this was their part, which staggered me that no one from the then senior team in finance had availed you that information. Can you give us an assurance now that you're confident that the COAB team will keep you available of any potential threats on contractual matters moving forward? And can you give this committee an assurance that we're not likely to face any further contractual errors moving forward?
No. She kind of thought that's what you were going to say.
I, lots of flippant response.
No, of course.